a tutti, bentornati in un nuovo video. Welcome back to another video. In today's video, I want to cover a topic that is very common in conversations. What I'm talking about is sports. Today, we will cover many common sports in Italian and we will also learn the verbs that are needed with those sports. In Italian, sports can be preceded by different verbs like fare or giocare, and there is not a specific rule when it comes to which verb should be used. However, there is a little rule that can help you sometimes in guessing what the correct verb could be. If we're talking, for example, of an individual sport or a sport played by two people, then it's more common to use the verb fare. On the other hand, if it's a team sport or a sport that involves a larger group, then in that case it's more common the verb giocare. But that is not always the case. Of course, there are exceptions, but this is a little rule that can help you identify which could be the correct verb. But now let's start and let's jump into our list of verbs and our list of sports, and we will also make some examples that will help you understand how to use the sport and the verb together. If you've been to Italy or if you're learning Italian, you probably know what the most common and popular sport in Italy is. And of course, it is soccer. So it is time to translate it. Soccer is translated into il calcio. Il refers to the article. I will also add the article, that way you know if the noun is masculine or feminine, and that will help you if you ever need to use one of these nouns. The verb that goes with soccer, with calcio, is giocare. So let's make a sentence. Luigi gioca a calcio tutti i venerdì. Let's translate it. Luigi plays soccer every Friday. On to the second sport, basketball. So basketball in Italian is translated into la pallacanestro. However, a lot of people in speaking terms say basket, but anyways, the correct word is la pallacanestro. Again, here we have a team sport, so the verb that we're using is giocare. So giocare a pallacanestro. Let's make one sentence with that. Basketball is one of the most popular sports in the United States. La pallacanestro è uno degli sport più popolari negli Stati Uniti. Next sport, volleyball. Volleyball is translated into la pallavolo. It's a feminine word and the verb that goes with it is giocare. So giocare a pallavolo. Gioco a pallavolo sulla spiaggia. I play volleyball at the beach. And then we have ski. This is translated into lo sci. And to ski has a verb itself. It doesn't go with either giocare or fare, but you simply translate to ski into sciare. I like to ski with friends. Mi piace sciare con amici. Another sport that has a verb on its own is swimming. So first let's translate swimming, which is il nuoto. And the verb that is used is a verb on its own and it is to swim, nuotare. When I was 4, I didn't know how to swim. Quando avevo 4 anni, non sapevo nuotare. Then we have an easy sport, which is tennis, and this one is translated into il tennis, and the verb that goes with it is giocare. So giocare a tennis. Let's make one sentence. Do you want to play tennis with me? Let's translate it. Vuoi giocare a tennis con me? Same thing with golf. So golf, of course, is translated into il golf, and the verb that goes with it is giocare, so giocare a golf. Let's make a sentence. I play golf in a very nice golf course. Gioco a golf in un campo da golf molto bello. Sorry for the repetition of the word golf. Another sport that is very common is cycling. This one is translated into il ciclismo. However, there are two ways to translate to bicycle, because you can say fare ciclismo, but this one is a little bit too professional. It really sounds very professional, or that you do it on a very, very serious way. On the other hand, if you like to go cycling, like riding a bicycle, then the translation would be more andare in bicicletta. So let's make two sentences with each of the two expressions. Faccio ciclismo da 5 anni. I've been cycling since 5 years. Alice likes to ride a bike around the lake. A Alice piace andare in bicicletta attorno al lago. Next sport is running, la corsa. And here again we have a verb that goes on its own, without fare or without giocare. The verb is correre. When I go to the gym, I run for an hour. Quando vado in palestra, corro per un'ora. Next one is a sport I'm not very good at, which is skating or ice skating, and the translation in Italian is il pattinaggio. The verb again goes on its own, it's very similar, and it is pattinare. The sentence is I like ice skating, but I'm not good at it. Mi piace pattinare sul ghiaccio, ma non sono brava. And then we have rowing, which is il canotaggio. The verb that goes with it is fare, so fare canotaggio. The sentence is rowing is very tiring. Let's translate it, fare canotaggio è molto stancante. And then we have water polo. This one is translated into la pallanuoto. And the verb that goes with it is giocare, so giocare a pallanuoto. Mattia plays water polo in the school's swimming pool. So let's translate it. Mattia gioca pallanuoto nella piscina della scuola. Another sport which is more common in summertime is sailing, which is translated into la vela. Here there are many verbs that could work well with this sport, like veleggiare or navigare, but probably the most common one is andare in barca a vela or fare vela. He likes sailing even when the ocean is rough. Gli piace andare in barca a vela anche quando il mare è mosso. I think I mentioned many of the most popular sports and the most played sports. So now I will just give you a little list of a few additional sports that are maybe a little less common, but still worth translating. Gymnastics. La ginnastica. Horseback riding, l'equitazione. Fencing, la scherma. Boxing, il pugilato. Rugby, that's the same in Italian. Climbing, l'alpinismo. Even though climbing can have different translations, so please don't use only alpinismo. Alpinismo is really the act of climbing a mountain in a quite professional way, let's say, but there are many ways to translate the verb to climb. Weightlifting, sollevamento pesi. Snowboard, that's the same, and it is lo snowboard. Okay guys, this is it for today's video. Please keep in mind that these sports can work with also different verbs. Of course, you can use verbs like to practice, praticare, or to exercise, esercitarsi, or to train, allenarsi, and many others. So these are usually the verbs that go with that sport, but of course, if you use other verbs, sento will still be correct and will still be understood by Italians, so don't worry about that. I hope this video was helpful and I hope you learned some new vocabulary words as well as some new verbs, and I will see you on the next video with a vlog or with a grammar lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a like, and ci vediamo alla prossima. Ciao!